heard that Hebrew letters contain pictographic meanings, which can be decoded to reveal hidden messages. The idea is that the letters in the Hebrew alphabet were originally pictures, and if you interpret the quote-unquote ancient pictographic meanings of each letter, you can discover deeper nuances of Hebrew words. For instance, in a teaching series promised to, quote, radically affect your understanding of the scriptures, one teacher named Jim Staley demonstrates how this interpretive methodology works. Quote, "The first two letters of the Hebrew alphabet are Aleph and Bet. Aleph means strength, power, leader, and Bet means house. Together, those two letters mean the strength of the house. Furthermore, together, Aleph and Bet also spell the Hebrew word Av, which means father. Our father is the strength of our house." So, here's what you do to decode these secret messages encoded in Hebrew words. You recognize the picture represented by each Hebrew letter. Then, when you put the pictures together, it reveals a message. Voila! As we saw in the example we just read, since Aleph was initially a picture of an ox head, it carries the meaning of strength, apparently because of the hard work the animal did, or so it is said. Bet was initially a picture of a house. Therefore, the hidden meaning encoded in the Hebrew word for father, Av, is the strength of the house. Remarkably, when we submit our lives to our Father in heaven, he becomes the strength of our house, right? Or perhaps you could say that since the father of the family is the head of the household, he is the strength of the house. There are all sorts of things you can contrive from this methodology. You can pretty much make words mean whatever you want. Who needs to learn Hebrew? Astonishingly, however, the example that we just went through is on the milder end of this wild spectrum of imagination. My favorite hidden message I've heard derived from Hebrew word pictures is one from Rob Skiba, and it is that the name Yeshua contains a prophecy about how the Messiah will destroy the Illuminati. I'm serious. Yeshua is spelled Yod Shin Vav Ayin. Yod is a picture of a hand. Sheen is a picture of teeth and means to consume or destroy, I guess because teeth are what one uses to consume food. Vav is a picture of a nail and means to establish, I guess because nails are used to establish things, like build houses, I don't know. Finally, Ayin is a picture of an eye. Therefore, Yeshua means the hand that destroys, the establishment of the eye. And did you know that the Illuminati symbol is the all-seeing eye? Incredible, right? Like I said, you can come up with all sorts of junk like this. Now, while this interpretive methodology is trendy among Fringianics, scholars universally reject it. Semitic scholars Dr. Michael Heiser and Dr. Michael Brown call it nonsense and even dangerous false teaching. No scholarly lexicon defines Hebrew words according to the alleged pictographic meanings of the Hebrew letters. Nowhere do you find this methodology in any ancient Jewish writings, the Dead Sea Scrolls, Targumim, Pseudepigrapha, Josephus, Philo, and so forth, or the rabbinic literature, the Mishnah, Talmud, and Midrash, none of it contains this methodology. This idea literally just pops up out of nowhere in the past 30 years or so. But besides there being literally no evidence of this methodology in ancient literature, why do scholars universally reject the idea of Hebrew word pictures? Well, for one, the premise of the methodology is entirely bogus. As Dr. Brown explains, the ancient Hebrew script, called Paleo-Hebrew, which was used in writing the earliest books of the Bible, is simply an alphabet and has no pictographic meaning. Any linguist familiar with the material knows that by the time a written language develops into an alphabet, it is no longer pictographical. In other words, the letters no longer stand for pictures. They only stand for sounds. The development of the alphabet simplified written communication significantly. Pictographic communication needed thousands of symbols, and an alphabet usually requires fewer than 30 symbols. Quote, "The genius of the alphabet was to isolate the most basic sounds used in a language, normally between 20 to 30, and to find single symbols, the letters of the alphabet, to convey these sounds." In the Hebrew alphabet, out of hundreds of symbols, 22 were chosen to represent sounds based on the first syllable of the original picture meaning. Thus, the Hebrew letter bet, for example, came to represent the sound b. It no longer represented a house, only a sound. In other words, even though the earliest forms of the letters that make up the Hebrew alphabet evolved from pictographs, the letters no longer maintained the meaning of the pictures when the Hebrew alphabet was developed. The letters no longer represented pictures, only sounds. Therefore, interpreting Hebrew words in the Bible according to the quote-unquote pictographic meanings of the letters is invalid. Consider this. According to the logic behind the idea of Hebrew word pictures, English words can be decoded in the same way, as Dr. Brown explains. Interestingly, the ancient Greeks also borrowed the ancient Phoenician alphabet, which was subsequently borrowed by the Romans, ultimately used in our English alphabet. So the ancient Phoenician Hebrew letter bet is actually our English letter B, and its rounded form resembles its ancient form depicting a house. This means that interpreting the quote-unquote pictographic meaning of Hebrew words makes as much sense as interpreting the pictographic meaning of English words. Are we going to start pulling random words out of Mark Twain's novels and decoding prophecies? That would be ridiculous, right? The English language doesn't work that way, as we all know. Well, neither does Hebrew. It never did. Shamefully, I admit that I bought into this idea in my earlier days as a messianic believer, and I know many others have as well. But it's time to let this flawed interpretive methodology die. I hope this video helps expose some of the problems with the Hebrew word pictures idea so that we all stop profaning our Messiah's name by our foolishness. Let's focus on learning truth and making a real difference in the world for God's glory. Hey everyone, thanks for watching. I hope this video blessed you. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to leave your thoughts in the comments below. Also, please subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you'll be notified when I release more content like this. Thank you again. Blessings and shalom.